If you're struggling to find a tech job in 2025, trust me, you're not alone. The job market is tougher than ever, and it feels like for every job posting, you want 5 years of experience for an entry role. Frustrating, right? In this video, I'm going to break down exactly how we are going to stand out, get noticed by recruiters, and land your first tech job, whether you are a fresh graduate or switching your career, or you are a self-taught developer. So if you're tired of rejection mails and trying to crack the code of getting your dream job, trust me, this video might be a game changer for you. Without further ado, let's get started. First step is going to be developing relevant skills. So whether you're going in software engineering side or cloud computing side, automation side, you need to have these fundamentals of networking, cloud computing, programming, or AI in order to thrive in the tech industry. Now we know that the future is the AI, automation, cloud computing. And one thing that we can't forget is that networking is the backbone of all of these technologies. Without network, how the hell can we communicate? So in order to thrive or to land your first tech job, get all these fun basics, develop these skills, develop. There are tons of free courses that you do, which are offered by AWS Skill Builder and also Google Cloud Skill Boost and also by Cisco Networking Academy. I have done all of these courses and linked in my LinkedIn portfolio. So you can visit my LinkedIn profile by following the link in the description box below so you can get an answer. An idea, particularly what kind of courses and the projects that I have done to land my first tech job. And also another thing is that experience is king. So before you are going to get your first tech job, in order to at least get a first technical interview, you need to get hands-on labs or you have to do projects.
Let me walk you through the some of the projects that I did in order to get a land tech job. So the first one is going to be creating a ping verification system and also hotel management network design projects, setting up a CI/CD pipeline from GitHub Actions, and lastly a small network office such as a Soho system built with Cisco Packet Tracer. I hope this helps.
Number two is gaining practical experience. So internships and entry-level jobs are a must look out for you guys if you're looking for, in order to gain the experience. And also you can gain a simple experience by doing the hands-on labs, you know, else you are contributing for open source projects, which is if you're a software engineer or a software engineering student, you can go and contribute to the open source projects that are in the GitHub. And also students, for people who are like to pursue their tech jobs in networking or cloud computing, you can do hands-on labs, which are also included in the AWS Skill Builder and Google Cloud Skill Boost as well. For especially for networking students, I would really recommend this. Either install the Cisco Packet Tracer or the GNS app and start doing all the networking, building networkings from setting up a small network lab, and also building a network management system. There are lots of YouTube tutorials that you can look into and start doing these labs. These help you to get an experience while you are doing this and documenting all the projects that you have done and listing them on your CV and also in your LinkedIn. The recruiters get an idea that you have some sort of experience and knowledge regarding these projects and real-time based scenarios, and they are quite aware that you are really passionate about what you are going to do. Step number three is building a strong resume and a portfolio. Let's keep portfolio a bit aside. So when it comes to resume, first of all, this resume is not acceptable anymore. This is the resume that you need to start working on and applying for all the job posting that you see on LinkedIn or any job posting site. This is known as ATS resume, or application tracking system friendly resume. So for example, this is a resume which lists down all your whole portfolio, what you have done, your experience, your education, the projects that you have done, the certifications that you have get. The recruiter who see this resume gets an idea about who you are, what you have done, and all the things. So because of that, rather than putting your photo and all this resume, start working on this ATS friendly resume, because this is the resume that all of the recruiters are currently accepting. I have made my one. And also another tip is that when you see a job posting, go through the job posting description below and see the list of the skills that they have listed down below. And according to that, if you feel like you have these skills, customize your skills section. And also if you have any projects done, list them and make them accessible and start applying. And also you should make sure to keep your CV from 1 to 2 pages minimum, because they do not like to have seeing like 3 to 4 pages big resumes. The more you keep your CV concise, the more it easier get for recruiters to go through your CV and get the basic idea about your career thing, about your whole portfolio. And also make sure to start job hunting from the apps like LinkedIn, because LinkedIn is the best app according for myself, because when I first went to land my first tech job, it really helped me to network with other networking people, networking professionals, and also because once you have a very well developed LinkedIn profile, it's also like it gives an idea for all those people, like what kind of person you are. Are you really ambitious? Are you a heavy techie person? What types of certifications and all the things that you have done regarding jobs and all the certifications, which is very important at the same time. So make sure to develop and enhance your LinkedIn profile as well. Especially for a tech professional, LinkedIn is a must because it's your whole appearance. Number 4, network and job hunts. So one thing you can do is joining the networking communities, especially tech communities. You can engage in networking forums, join to networking groups, especially in Facebook, LinkedIn, and Discord communities, because these people really share knowledges and all the job postings and what are the trends that are coming. Really, it's a root source of learning for you to look out for, because as a tech person, one thing you need to be aware of that is that tech is changing, and so you really need to be updated in order to thrive in the industry. Once you land your tech job, that's something you need to start working on. When you're going to connect to conferences, you get a whole lot of idea, because these conferences are conducted by all these tech giants. For example, because all the AWS, all the Google, and all these Microsoft people are conducting lots of huge conferences in order to tell what are the upcoming releases or the trends that they are going to set up in the future. So tech people can understand when they're working in the real world scenario, these types of things can be applicable. Yeah. And the next thing is, which is very, very important for a fresh graduate or a person, you need to seek out for job referrals. Especially if job referrals need to be included in your CV as well, it might be your networking, it might be a university lecturer or your peer who is working with you in, technically it's a college, out to contacts for internal job referrals. And the next thing is apply and prepare for interview. Once you get and land an interview, you need to apply for targeted roles that matches your experience and your skills, customizing your resume for each. And when it comes to interview prep, go through the common tech questions that they get for each role. For example, if you are going to get interview for a software engineer role, type in the Google software engineering interview questions. And there are tons of interview questions and answers that have been uploaded to the net. Go through them, get an idea. And one thing, do not ever do this mistake. Learn the answers straight away and go and say it in the interview, because the recruiters know that you are saying something that you have learned from the internet. So instead, answer the questions confidently, ambitiously. Interview, make sure to do some troubleshooting scenarios, real world lab buildings, because this helps you to get an idea and how to answer the questions that they ask from the real world based scenarios. And also they might be asking all these behavioral questions like, tell me about yourself, In this moment, you should be know how to answer these questions. There is a separate videos and tutorials in YouTube where you can go and seek for an idea about it. Yeah. Yeah, and that's all for today's video. I hope you found this helpful. I really wanted to make this very simple and easy step-by-step guide. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below and I will be happy to answer them. And just like that, I will see you in my next video. Bye.